Rosalind this week, she's not here at the minute. So welcome to Matilda. For some of the kids, it's their second time. They've loved it the last time they came back. So it's an extract from Matilda, so it's not the entire play. We couldn't fit that in a week. So the kids have had, they've been a brilliant, brilliant group. We've done arts and crafts, singing, dancing, acting, everything like that, and put the play together in 15 hours, including giving them breaks and things like that. So they've been working really, really hard. They've made great friends over the week, so they've had a ball. So hopefully you will enjoy the show. They're very nervous. Some of them, they're so nervous out there. So please smile, encourage, clap, sing along with them, because it's not easy getting up in front of your parents doing this. So please show them as much encouragement as you can. So a big clap for our Matilda cast.
Because she she sure as heck won't get a job anywhere else.
Oh, Charlotte!
It is a curious trick that grasshoppers have their hearing organs in the sides of their abdomen. Your daughter Jemima, judging by what she has learnt this term, has no hearing organs at all.
Oh, Jemima!
I'm not listening.
Georgina has the same glacial beauty as an iceberg. But unlike the iceberg, she is absolutely nothing below the surface.
This is disgraceful!
Occasionally, one comes across parents who take the opposite line, who show no interest at all in their children. Mr. and Mrs. Wormwood are two such parents.
They had a daughter called Michaela and a daughter called Matilda.
And her parents looked upon Matilda
as nothing more than a scab. Pack up your troubles in your old kid bag. Don't worry about the cavalries. I don't care what the people may say, what the people may say about me.
You're scussing little tadpole.
You're a ghastly maggot, Matilda.
Matilda's sister Michaela was perfectly normal, but Matilda was something to make your eyes pop.
By the age of one.
She knew as many words as the grown-ups.
By the age of three.
She taught herself to read by studying newspapers.
By the age of four.
She could read fast and began hankering after books.
Daddy, do you think you could buy me a book?
A book? What do you want a flaming book for?
To read.
Got a perfectly good TV over there, 12-inch screen and all. You're asking for a book?
You are getting spoiled, my dear.
Die! Yes!
Oh, Matilda, really do be quiet. I'm off to the bingo.
And I'm off to work. Come on, Michaela.
Yes, Dad. And you have to stay here all by yourself.
Well, there's nothing else for. I'm off to the library.
Where are the children's books, please? They're over there in the lower shelf. Would you like me to find you a book with some nice pictures in them?
No, thank you. I will manage.
From then on, every afternoon, when Matilda's mother headed off to bingo, Matilda toddled on down to the library.
I've read all the children's books. I wonder what book to read next.
Exactly. How old are you?
4 years and 3 months.
What kind of book would you like to read next?
A famous one that grown-ups read.
Try this. I must be mad.
Wow, great expectations.
Great expectations?
Over the next 6 months, Matilda read the following books.
Nicholas Nickleby.
Oliver Twist.
Jane Eyre.
Pride and Prejudice.
The Invisible Man. The books transported her into new worlds. She went to Africa with Hemingway.
Rawr!
And to India with Kipling. She went all over the world while sitting in a library in an English village.
Hi-ho, hi-ho. It's off to school we go. We work all day and get no play. Hi-ho, 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 hi-ho.
You've all got your pencils, I hope.
Yes, Miss Honey.
Good. Now, it's the first day of school for each one of you. It is the beginning of at least 11 long years of schooling, which you've all to go through. Your headmistress is Miss Trunchbull.
Dun, dun, dun.
Now, let me tell you something about her. She insists upon strict discipline throughout the school. And take my advice. Always behave in front of her.
Never answer me back.
Yes, sir.
Never argue with me.
Yes, sir.
Always do as I say.
Yes, sir.
If you don't, I'll liquidize you like a carrot in a kitchen blender.
Yes, sir.
Have you got the message?
Yes, Miss Honey.
Good. Now it's time to introduce yourselves. I must get to know you all.
I'm Billy, and I like to skip.
My name's Annabelle, and I like to hop.
I'm Jessie, and I like to listen to music.
I'm Kayla, and I like to pick on my sister Matilda.
I'm
Lily and I like lollipops.
My name's Maggie and I like singing.
You're on the phone with your girlfriend, she loves that.
Well done, Maggie.
I'm Emily and I like to swim.
I'm Matilda and I like to read.
Really, Matilda? Good joke. Now, children, hands up anyone who can spell cat. Yes?
C-A-T.
Good girl. Now, Matilda, you said you could read. Can you read a verse from this book?
An epicure dining at Crewe found a rather large mouse in his stew. Cried the reader, do not shout or wave about, or the rest will be wanting one too.
Oh my, well I never. What books have you read, Matilda?
I'm very fond of Charles Dickens. He makes me laugh a lot.
I'm gobsmacked.
Look at all the new rats that are going to annoy me this year.
Good morning, Miss Trunchbull.
Good morning, Miss Trunchbull.
You all look horrid. Little girls are disgusting.
Hey mama, welcome to the 60s.
watching our favourite TV programme.
Look, this is most inconvenient. How about you come back some other time?
If you think some rotten TV programme is more important than your daughter's future, then you ought not to be a parent. Why don't you switch the darn thing off and listen to me?
You are so annoying. We are watching TV. Can you not just come back some other time and give us peace?
God, you're so noisy.
Hey, she's your daughter. How come you don't care about her?
Okay, fine. So, what's your point?
Oh, man, she don't have a point.
Okay, what I'm going to tell you is, I've noticed Matilda's doing a really good job in class, and she told me nobody taught her to read or to multiply.
You're a twit. She's lying.
I don't know if she's lying or not, but my point is she has an excellent mind. But I expect you knew that already.
Of course I knew she could read. She spends her whole life up in her room with some silly books.
You should be happy. A little five-year-old girl reading long adult novels by Dickens and Hemingway.
Dickens and Hemingway!
Doesn't that make you jump up and down with excitement?
A girl to think about making herself look attractive so she'd get a good husband later on. Looks are way more important than books.
You, come here.
Ow.
Nerd, who said you let some stranger into our house?
She's not a stranger. She's my teacher, Miss Honey.
I don't care what honeybee she is. She's wasting my time. I've missed an episode. Don't you know Lance is going to propose to London?
Next up, Lance is going to propose to London. So stay tuned, folks.
You are grounded. No books, no school. Understood?
What's wrong? Why are you crying?
Mommy and Daddy grounded me. No books and no school.
How dare they?
It's quite late now. Maybe you should go.
Okay, but feel free to call. Everything will be fine. And don't stay up too long.
I will. Thank you, Miss Honey.
What will happen to Matilda?
Who can tell?
If I had my way, I'd push her down a well.
Push her down a well?
Silence! I will get out of this house. Just you wait and see. This is not the last time people have heard of me.
Yeah!
That tonight's gonna be